Hi friends, welcome to another weekend of our Children's Liturgy of the Word. I'm so happy that you are here to join us in this very first Sunday in May. We are inching closer and closer and closer to summertime, and it's amazing. So I'm glad that you're here to join us, and I'm glad that we are going to be talking about Jesus and learning all about him more and more and more each week. Now, we are still in the season of Easter. It's our fifth Sunday of Easter, and all of our presiders are wearing white still, because again, remember, white is the most special color for a most special season in our church here. So we're going to keep on learning about Jesus during this Easter season. Now today, Jesus tells us a story about grapes on a vine. He tells us that his father is the gardener who tends to the vine. I'm not a very good gardener, so that's why I'm glad God is in control of that. We are the grapes on the vine because the father is the one who gardens and tends to the vine, so he takes care of us. God shows us his love, and we have to go out and show the world our love in exchange. The next time you drink some grape juice, I want you to think about God and how we are the grapes and he is the gardener who keeps us all on the vine safe. Now in the gospel today, Jesus tells us that we can do a lot of good in the world, but only if we stay connected to him, just like the grapes have to stay connected to the vine. So let's listen to what Jesus has to say. The Lord be with you. And with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts away every branch of mine that does not produce fruit, but he trims clean every branch that does produce fruit, so that it will produce even more fruit. You are already clean because of what I have said to you. Stay joined to me and I will stay joined to you. Just as the branch cannot produce fruit unless it stays joined to the vine. You cannot produce fruit unless you stay joined to me. I am the vine and you are the branches. If you stay joined to me and I stay joined to you, then you will produce lots of fruit. But you cannot do anything without me. Stay joined to me and let my teachings become part of you. Then you can pray for whatever you want and your prayer will be answered. When you become fruitful disciples of mine, my Father will be honored. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good job, everybody. Great listening. I hope that you really heard what Jesus had to say, because what he was telling us is that we are like the branches on this plant right here. It's a very pretty plant because there's some purple mixed in with the green, and you can see the branches on this plant. Now, God in heaven is like the person who cares for this plant. We have a wonderful team of people here at the church that takes care of all of our plants. And the leafy branches add to the beauty of this world, but only if they stay attached to the vine. What would happen if I just cut a branch off? Well, that's what happens to you when you cut yourself off from Jesus by sinning. The part that gets cut off will die. So we want to stay connected by God by doing our best to not sin. Do you know anyone who grows grapevines or like an apple tree where they live in their yard maybe, or maybe at an apple orchard close to their house? Then you know that sometimes a person needs to do some trimming to make room for bigger and for better fruit. In that same way, God takes something away from you, but only so that you can become more fruitful. Jesus says, when you become fruitful disciples of mine, my Father will be honored. That's what happens when you do what you were born to do, to spread God's good news and to be fruitful, meaning to spend out, give out, produce great, beautiful fruit for the world to share in. Now, I want everybody to stand up because we're going to tell the world exactly what we believe. And we're going to do that by shouting, yes, I do believe. Do you believe you live and grow in the garden of God, your loving creator? Yes, I do believe. Do you believe you have faith through Jesus Christ, God's only Son? Yes, I do believe. Do you believe Jesus shares with you his Holy Spirit? Yes, I do believe. I want you to fold your hands and bow your heads and put God in your heart. And I want you to listen to the words that we're going to pray today. In God's garden, Jesus is the vine and we are the branches. Because we cannot do anything without Jesus, let us pray for his help wherever it is most needed in our world. We pray that everywhere on earth, leaders of the church will help people connect with Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that here in our parish, we will live fruitful lives and give honor to God our Father. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that in Brunswick, Ohio, we will truly help others and not just talk about it. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Now put that one person in your heart who needs Jesus the most in their life this week. And let us pray. Jesus said that if we stay joined to him and learn his teachings, we can pray for whatever we want and our prayers will be answered. That's because we'll so much be like him that we ask for today. We ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. All right, boys and girls, this week I want you to go out and I want you to be fruitful. I want you to spread God's word in kind acts, in kind words, and being the best person that you can be, just like Jesus would want you to be. And that will honor God. Have a great week, and I can't wait to see you again.